Okay, thank you very much for this enriching presentation. Now to move to the next presenter, Pınar Duru. She is going to talk about the COVID-19 effects on breastfeeding behaviors. I think this will be an interesting talk to listen as well. So if you are ready, you can start.
Hello to everyone. First of all, if I need to introduce myself, I'm working as an assistant professor doctor in public health department in Eskişehir Osman Gazi University. 1 minute. Can you see my screen?
Yes, it's okay. We can see it.
Sorry. Our title is Evolution of Breastfeeding Behaviors with Breastfeeding Women's Impact Level of Events to COVID-19 Pandemic Process and Application of the Recommended Rules. Breastfeeding women with a higher risk of getting infection depending on physical, hormonal and mental alteration in their body during pregnancy and the postpartum period are among the groups where COVID-19 may pose a risk. However, when studies conducted in specific COVID-19 are examined, no evidence that women who are in pregnancy or the postpartum period have higher ratios of getting an infection than other people is found. Due to the pandemic, women experience many concerns regarding the pregnancy and postpartum period. In this study, it was aimed to determine the level of stress caused by the events experienced due to the COVID-19 pandemic to breastfeeding women and to evaluate the breastfeeding behaviors and the compliance level of breastfeeding women with the rules established against the risk of coronavirus. Our research questions are like that: what is the level of impact of the events during COVID-19 pandemic on breastfeeding women, or what is the level of breastfeeding women compliance with the rules established against the risk of coronavirus during the pandemic? How is the reflection of the COVID-19 pandemic on breastfeeding behaviors of women? A cross-sectional online survey design was used. This design was preferred due to its advantage in determining the cause-effect relationship at the same time in a given time period and providing a quick status determination in the COVID-19. For the study, the approval of the Ministry of Health Scientific Research Platform and the ethical permission from university's ethic committee were obtained. Data collection work was conducted throughout Turkey between the dates of April and May 2020. All mothers who were breastfeeding during the study date composed the target population of the study. Sample selection was not made in the study, and mothers over the age of 18 who agreed to participate in the research and were literate were invited over the internet. 339 breastfeeding mothers participated in the study. The postdoc power obtained for the achievable sample size calculated through the G-Power program. In the analysis made with 0.05 alpha error margin and 339 sample volume and moderate effect size, the strength of the study was determined to be 19%, and it was observed that the number of samples was sufficient. Data collection tools such as within the scope of the study, the impact of event scale revise were used to determine the stress of breastfeeding women experienced due to trauma caused by pandemic with 7 questions to determine the sociodemographic characteristic and breastfeeding behaviors of the participants. High score indicates high levels of traumatic stress for the scale. In the analysis of the data, in addition to describe statistics such as frequency, mean, standard deviation, median, etc., the Kiskar test was used to determine the relationship between nominal variables. Findings, the average age of the mothers participating in the study was 30 years, and 62.2% of them are bachelor's degree. 39.2% of breastfeeding mothers were traumatically affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. Only 4.1% of breastfeeding mothers stated that they complied with all 14 rules that the Ministries of Health has established as a protector against COVID-19 risk. The most common rule applied by breastfeeding mothers was to wash their hands frequently with soap and water for at least 20 seconds. To 2071 of the mothers stated that human milk would be protective against COVID-19 by strengthening the infant's immune system, while 81 were concerned about the possibility of transmitting COVID-19 to the infant through human milk. After the COVID-19 outbreak, 33.6% of the mothers stated that they altered their infant diets, and 2.1% of them stated that they stopped giving human milk to their infant. The ones above color degree feeding their infants with human milk whenever they want during the day frequently ventilate the environments think that human milk was protective against COVID-19 by strengthening their infant's immune system. Conclusions, the study results reveals that breastfeeding mothers were affected by the events experienced as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic and concerned about the risk of transmission to their infants through human milk or breastfeeding, and the ratios of compliance with the recommended protective measures were low. So policymakers and healthcare providers shouldn't ignore this situation. It may be beneficial to conduct conscious raising and awareness studies to increase the compliance ratios of breastfeeding women with the recommended measures to prevent COVID-19 transmission. Breastfeedings need to be promoted throughout through the COVID-19 pandemic. So this is my presentation. Actually, I wasn't prepared to give a presentation in English, so my pronunciation, if my presentation is was bad, sorry for this.
Thank you very much for your presentation. Especially the topic was really interesting. And I am talking personally, of course. Thank you very much. If there are any questions or comments, now I may give the floor for the comments.